Hi everyone, welcome to the next video in our Partner Innovation Series. Today we're talking to Michel Morvan, who's the co-founder and executive chairman of Cosmo Tech. Welcome, Michel. It's great to sit down with you today and learn more about Cosmo Tech's simulation digital twins technology.
Thank you, Tony. Hi everybody, very excited to be here today.
Fantastic. So Michel, why don't you tell me a little bit about Cosmo Tech and your solutions.
Well, Cosmo Tech is a next generation hybrid AI technology powered by a unique modeling language. This language grew out of 10 years of academic research in complex systems modeling and has been augmented by 10 additional years of development by our engineers at Cosmo Tech. So our solutions, which are based on this technology, they enable complex organizations to predict possible futures, overcome uncertainty, and lead transformational business outcomes. Simulation digital twins, that's their name, can be applied to many sectors. It's mainly limitless, whether it's manufacturing, energy utilities, transport, or even cities. All these complex industries and organizations are now facing the same major challenges, and these are very, very big challenges. These companies have a need to adapt quickly and reconcile many conflicting objectives, such as efficiency, resilience, or sustainability, cost reduction. And at the same time, they lack visibility and understanding of the impact actions taken or disruptions will have on their whole organization. So our technology brings this visibility. And more importantly, it brings the ability to simulate what is going to happen, making it possible to understand how, when, and what will happen if you do this or if you do that. What will be the cascading effects across the entire value chain if a disruption occurs here or there? We have a bold ambition to make simulation digital twins easy to build and use so that any business anywhere on the planet can transform and reach its full potential. Combining Azure IoT and digital twin services and Cosmo Tech simulation technology, you can monitor the present and predict the future. And to be very transparent, we can't wait to see this vision coming to life with our partnership with you guys at Microsoft.
Fantastic. Yes, very cool. So your customers are using, you know, your solutions to effectively buffer themselves from risk, right? So can you give me an example of how does this help their bottom line?
Well, sure. Let's take one example. One customer, a global manufacturer, wanted to optimize their sourcing strategy in China. By creating a digital twin of their network and production sources, they use simulation to generate a 5% increase of global profit margin. Among the cost savings they found, they were able to reduce, for example, custom and transport costs, and therefore, of course, CO2 emission, by 60%. What was interesting is that the resulting strategy was the opposite of what they intuitively expected to see. I have another example in the energy sector. Electric transmission utilities in Europe are under a lot of pressure today to ensure the modernization and reliability of their energy network. They, of course, also have high risk and expected investment due to aging workforce and evolving energy sources with the arriving of renewables. Using simulation, one large utility customer is able to save 10% on their annual maintenance and renewal budget for the same level of service. And we are talking about budget ranking in the hundreds of millions of euros. And they also reduced operational conflicts by 20%.
Wow, these are like massive savings, right? And it seems like with the right, you know, level of data, you can make a huge impact. That's awesome. So Michel, let's switch gears a little bit. You know, now let's talk about the technology. Can you tell us a little bit more about what are the underlying technologies that you use in your platform?
Yes, of course. So the important thing is, I mentioned the fact that we are hybrid AI, right? But the important thing here is that our approach is different from pure data-driven technology. Our modeling is not based on past data only. We also replicate the dynamics of the organization defined with human knowledge, which is the way the system evolves with its causal rules, all the interactions of its present and future components. So in this way, using this hybrid AI, we can provide a 360-degree model and view of the dynamic behavior of the most complex organization, including not just physical assets, but also flows, employee skills, limits in HR capacity, financial risk, and so on and so forth. As a result, our technology, which is, of course, integrated with Azure Digital Twin, offers an extremely large simulation capacity, both in terms of the numbers of scenarios and the complexity of scenarios that can be run across the organization. This means that you can predict unlimited possible futures of an organization, even under conditions that have never occurred before.
That's really fascinating. And I really love the fact that you're creating simulated models, you know, based on human thinking and, you know, scientific principles. But, you know, at the same time, Michel, human beings are fallible. You know, what if they're asking the wrong question, or maybe a question that has unseen, you know, consequences? What do you do in that situation?
Well, that first, it happens. And that's why the technology is also so useful. Because if we go back to what I said, I shared earlier, the first thing that simulation digital twin bring is the ability to simulate the impact of a decision or a disruption on the whole organization, breaking down silos and contradictory views. So the point is, decision makers can simulate unlimited what-if scenarios across their entire system to predict all possible outcomes of future plans, and of course, uncovering any potential conflicts. Then what will be the systemic consequences and my best options for dealing with the budget reduction in OPEX and CAPEX, a raw material supply shortage? That's exactly the kind of questions you can answer with this tool. And the time frame for this simulation can be the next 30 minutes in some cases, or the next 30 years, depending on the use case or business objectives you're working with. So with these scenarios, both operational managers and the C-suite executive can confidently explore possible options, weigh impact to make optimal choices, identify the strengths and weaknesses of an approach before it is implemented, and try strategies that have not yet been tested before.
Yeah, you know, at the end of the day, you bring up a very good point. This is all about the management, you know, having the confidence and the ability to make the right business decisions. So how does this solution help make those business decisions?
Well, simulation digital twins offer confidence in decision-making because they offer organization transparency on who and why an outcome is achieved. And this comes from the capacity to identify the causes behind the result. Then decision makers can explain the reasons behind results to all stakeholders, ensuring adoption, which is, as you know, a very, very important point in these digital transformations. They can show every step of the way from KPIs to implementation guidance. So as an example, RTE, which is the French Electric Transmission Utility, used our solution to justify its business plan to the French Energy Regulatory Commission and backing up their decisions or their propositions with facts, they obtained a 15% increase in their budget, showing that increasing the maintenance budget will lead to substantial savings on the overall budget in the medium term, which was impossible to know without these simulation digital twins.
Yeah, so with that answer, you know, I'm sure everybody would want, you know, a simulation digital twin. And, you know, most of the businesses are aware of the value of cloud-based you know, data-driven analytics, but clearly you guys have taken it far beyond that. And, you know, your use of knowledge-based AI to enable prescriptive and not just predictive analytics, I think it's amazing. Can you tell me a little bit more about that predictivity?
Yes, yes, you're right. And it's very exciting. Incorporating knowledge-based AI allows us to move beyond data-driven analytics, which is something I mentioned before. We can predict scenarios that have not already happened, which is impossible using only past data to make predictions. If you use past data, you're going to predict things that more or less already happened. And modeling the dynamic behavior of the organization allows it to be projected into conditions also that have never occurred before. So we can detect emerging behavior, run new scenarios, reimagine operations. This is one we can move from predictive to prescriptive analytics with simulation digital twins. And more than that, in addition to what-if scenarios, our technology can provide how-to scenarios. You get an optimized and executable action plan calculated specifically for your chosen KPIs. As all significant parts of the organization are analyzed, you get unprecedented optimization. I talked very earlier about the additional 5% global profit achieved for a sourcing strategy. This result has been achieved with how-to optimization. The company automatically obtained the optimal plan with the analysis of 80,000 scenarios. So connected and synchronized with the real world, thanks to Azure Digital Twin, simulation digital twins bring autonomous decision-making or recommended actions for validation.
Yeah, that's fantastic, Michel. You know, one of your customers that we've talked to, you know, about your products, they were saying that first, you know, your product creates a classical risk metrics, then crosses that data with the probability of that event ever occurring again, and then calculating the outcomes based on the severity of the consequence of that event. So that is a lot of computational data. Can you give me an example of how customers would apply this to the real world scenarios?
Yes, of course. consider, for example, that you're managing a set of factories located across Europe and producing a large diversity of products. Some parts are produced in certain factories and then transported to others through a logistics system for the assembly process and then sent somewhere else to become part of the final product. And imagine now that you have a forecast of the demand for the final product over, let's say, the coming year. And you want to find the best way to organize this production to respond to the demand. Well, we have a digital twin of this production system, including parts, machines, factories, processes, stocks, employees, and the way they work, and when do they go on vacation, the cost, and so on and so forth. And you can use this simulation digital twin to run hundreds of thousands of simulations to find the best way to respond to this demand that you forecast. But of course, you also have to deal with a lot of uncertainties, like, for example, the volatility of the demand. You made a forecast on the demand, but who knows? But also risks related to the production capacity of your factories. What if one of your factory reduces its productivity because of a pandemic? These things happen. What risk related to logistics? What if a logistic route is closed because of an international crisis? What if the Suez Canal is blocked? Etc. You don't want your best solution that works perfectly in a perfect world to dramatically fail if one or more of these events happens, right? So as you said, we incorporate the events with a probability into the digital twin. And we now run again hundreds of thousands of simulations integrating these risks and their cascading effects. This allows us to find an optimal solution that has been constructed to be robust to these unexpected events.
Michel, you know, this is a fascinating discussion because you know, it's all about applying technology to solve business problems with real business value. You know, I just can't help but wonder what's next. You know, what's the future look like for simulation digital twin technology? So, you know, you guys are on the forefront of technology. What do you think this is going to keep going?
Oh, well, I think it's going to be, I mean, very big. So simulation digital twins, they bring a new way of understanding the business ecosystem and a new way of running it. They provide a unique 360-degree view of decision impacts from strategy to day-to-day operations by taking into account the cascading effects of unforeseen events. So it's sure that complexity and uncertainty will remain, and by the way, probably is going to grow. And what is clear is that systemic risks and or opportunities will drive organization growth, and I can say some, for, in some cases, life or death. So industries and organizations, from my perspective, will increasingly need to simulate everything holistically, enabling faster and more agile responses. The key point is having visibility. That's why simulation digital twin, which bring this visibility, will increasingly play a key role for their future. These technologies are not intended to replace human expertise. On the contrary, they will give decision makers additional scope to more easily redirect their actions or innovate in response to changing needs. They will considerably support leaders' organizations to be agile drivers of fundamental changes. So I repeat, I think it will be huge.
Hey, Michel, you've really brought to life the value of simulation, especially the business value, you know, of simulation and digital twins, which is quite fascinating. You know, I want to thank you so much for taking the time today and walking us through, you know, the powerful technology that you're providing and for being such an amazing partner. And I'm really excited about, you know, what we could do together on this digital transformation journey. Thank you so much, Michel.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Tony. It was great exchanging with you about all these exciting subjects.